How do you get copywriting clients if you don't have a portfolio or experience? It's almost like a catch-22 where clients want to see your previous work and how much experience you have, but you might not have anything to show just yet. It's really easy to get frustrated and confused when you're in this spot as a freelance writer because you want to close clients and you want to generate your income and boost revenue. But luckily, all hope is not lost because in this video, I'll be showing you actually how to build up your portfolio very quickly if you're brand new to writing, or even if you're a beginner and you have a little bit of momentum and you just want to improve it that little bit more. First things first, a portfolio is a massive asset as a writer. And in my experience, I might honestly go as far to say that it might be more valuable than testimonials and case studies. And why I say this is because I've worked with these big 7-8 figure plus companies, and they don't even look for testimonials or case studies. They just look at my previous work, my portfolio, and not only does that show them my writing skill, my writing style, and the different industries I can write for, but it's massive social proof. It's essentially case studies and testimonials combined in a lot of cases, because it shows that you're able to work with a really big company, they trust you, they could outsource that work, and you did a really good job. There's so many clients of mine that literally say, just because I wrote for XYZ big businesses, that was one of the reasons they actually converted and wanted to work with me. So it's really important as a writer, you build up your portfolio over time and you make it more impressive. And that's why number one, I recommend beginning with blogging. If you have no portfolio, go onto medium.com, create a free account and start blogging. You do have to blog about things a client would be interested in. So for example, if you want to target tech companies and startups, start talking about startup marketing and how to grow a tech company, you know, the tech industry growth and things like that. Something the client would find interesting and that they're actually searching up on Medium or Google. And what's really cool about this approach is not only if you're blogging every day, you're building up all these pieces of portfolios that you could actually show off, but the other thing is you're gonna have people coming to you. That Medium account is gonna get organic traffic from inside the platform and Google, especially because Medium has a really high domain authority, meaning that it looks big in the eyes of Google, and they'll rank that article more likely over smaller websites. So you actually get portfolio pieces and people might be coming to you naturally to reach out for services. Secondly, you should be writing mock projects and copy. Just because it isn't for a real business doesn't really make it any less than a real campaign or project. What you can do is take a particular topic, an industry, or even one of your favorite brands, you know, take Adidas, Nike, Reebok, whatever it is, and then choose something like a sales letter, a sales page, a blog post, the actual piece of material, and then write a mock project. But honestly, put as much time and effort as you would if it was a paid project. You want to make it as good as possible, so then when a client does see it or you hand it off to them, they can see that it's a really good job well done, and then they'll be way more likely to actually work with you. Thirdly, write for free. Honestly, there's nothing wrong in the very beginning with working for free, just for a small period. What I recommend is you hop on social media, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and to make a status that you're offering freelance writing services, you wanna build up your experience and your portfolio, and then you're gonna choose a few different businesses and write them some free content and copy. I also recommend heading over to writeit.com, going to the entrepreneur subreddit, or other subreddits too, should be good, and essentially promoting it in the same way. Say that you're trying to get good at content and copywriting, and you're willing to actually produce some free material for the first few people that contact you. Make sure to set some kind of limit or ceiling, or else you might just get swamped with work. Even if you do these three things for a short period, you're gonna amass a pretty impressive portfolio. So with the blogging, make sure you do that on a consistent long-term basis. That's not only good, like I said, for building portfolio, but also getting clients and driving a lot of traffic. Nowadays, I get pretty much all my clients through blogging and SEO. So it's something that if you can start early on, it's huge. If you want to learn more about getting better at copywriting or building a profitable online writing business, make sure to go into the description. I have free masterclasses and courses you can get 100% free. But other than that, as usual, thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next video.